In May 1983, Freddy chanced upon Montserrat Caballé, one of the greatest opera divas of all time, singing Verdi at Covent Garden Opera House. That night, an unexpected love affair was born.
She came on, she sang in that first bit, and at sort of the end of her bit, his jaw just sort of fell open. He says, "Look, when did she come back? When is she coming back again?" And that was how it all started.
He phoned me up in a great state of excitement one night, and he said, "You never guess what? I've had a message to say that Montserrat Caballé would like to meet me." And he said, "I'm not going without you."
It's amazing. I mean, now I'm going into opera, you know. Forget rock and roll.
The first meeting between Freddy and Montserrat took place in the Ritz Hotel in Barcelona.
It is the room where we first met. A piano was in the corner, well prepared. So we stand up from the table, we went to the corner, and he was playing, and I was beginning to sing. We could go on for hours and hours and hours. So when we finished, we look at each other, and I knew it, that he has conquered me.
One evening, after dinner at Freddy's London home, Freddy, Montserrat and Mike Moran spontaneously improvised around the piano. Now, 13 years later, Montserrat finally listens for the first time to the rare home recordings of Freddy playing her the ideas that would become their Olympic theme song and international hit, Barcelona.
It was a very special night, a very, very special night. I will never forget. It was so wonderful that we don't realize the time passed so fast, and then someone says, "Well, it's almost six. I think you have to stop because you have sung a concert and you have..." I said, "Yes, I'm tired, but it's so wonderful."
Every 5 minutes he would say, "Look, you've got to go home, you've got to catch a flight." She says, "Oh, you don't want me here?" He says, "No, I do want you here, but I don't want to get into trouble because you're tired and you're late."
"You're not tired, you're not tired now, huh? You must rest a little."
"You want me to go? I'm going."
"No, no, no, I don't want you to go. I think you must rest."
I sound so terrible.
"You sound..."
"No,
I can sing till 6 o'clock in the morning."
I think it was 6 o'clock in the morning, 1 a.m. when I left home, and all the people was in the street, was lots of people, you know, surprised as I spent the night at Freddy's home.
And I just thought, maybe one song or a duet, and that's... And she said, "Only one song, are you sure? You only want to do one song?" And I said, "Well, let's see how we get on, you know, if you like more of my music." And she said, "How many songs does a normal rock and roll album have?" And I said, "Something like 10. "Oh, we'll do 10 songs then." So, you know, so she just said, "Yes, write 10 songs, you know, like tomorrow." It's such a challenge, actually. That's going to be great, because I've never sort of thought of writing songs in that way. Now, she said she wants to do duets with me. I have to sort of think in a totally different way. I had this perfect dream. When your memory was, this dream was me and you. I want all the world to see.
For the opera world has been a revolution, a real revolution. It was like a distension, like a window open to the world.
Barcelona!
young people come today to the opera, they always say, we wanted so much to find out who is the woman that screams so much with Freddie. I have many proposals many times to do it again, something with other colleagues and things. But, you know, has to be something very special that follows Freddie and me together. Very special.